here moisture is added to the tobacco. But still, it's get about 24% moisture, which is where the tobacco could be handled for sorting, sizing, etc.
How long is it staying in there?
It's just about 1 day to the day. This already has the moisture content that we use for the salt. So we'll see. But it's not dry, it's pliable. So that's the way we need it to be. Black label and also Macanudo Inspirado Maduro. Those two brands.
Is it really true that women have better color perception than men? That's what they said in the video.
What they said?
That women have better color perception. That's why you let women sort.
That's why, and also their hands are more delicate.
I can see that. Yeah. For
I wonder if they truly do have more cones, color receptors in their eyes.
A leaf is broken.
Right.
So the breakage is.
Much more delicate.
That's the word. Much more delicate. So here, what they are doing is separating the leaves by grade. And the grades here are grueso, intermedio, and thin. So for black label, we only use two grades, grueso and intermedio, because those are the ones that have the potential to become maduro. The thin leaves do not have the texture to get the heat that needs to be supported in order to become maduro. And also, any leaf that is filler or short filler or not usable is separated here.
So is Connecticut going Habano? Is that what they're sorting?
Havana. Havana. Habano is from Cuba. This is a seed developed in Connecticut.
Okay.
There was an American guy that went to Cuba in the 1980s and looked for seeds from all over the Cuban country. Took it to the United States, started growing and crossing, and came out with that seed. That's why they call it Habano. That was main wrapper used in U.S. cigars prior to 1950, before they developed the Connecticut shape. Connecticut shape substituted this one. But it was used in cigars in the United States for a long time.
So,
and here we have a display here of the grade that we usually take from the Havana. These are the grueso leaves, are darker, thicker if you touch them. These are suitable for Maduro, for black label. Mm-hmm.
For Maduro. Yeah, suitable for Maduro.
These are intermediate, not so thick, but still good for Maduro. And these are the thin leaves that cannot become Maduro. So we have them for refrigerators. And these are loose leaf scraps, not usable. So that's what the ladies today are doing. They're separating the leaf by grade.
Yeah.
After the leaves are sorted by grade, we need to ferment them. In order to be able to ferment them, we tie the leaf in hand.
Tie the leaves in hands.
They tie it in hands and put approximately 25 leaves per hand.
Okay.
And then after that, we proceed to ferment.
Yep, definite ammonia in here.
You will feel the ammonia.
Oh, yes.
In the environment.
Not as intense as some places I've been, but.
Some places are bad. You can't walk inside.
Now you will see. We have two more.
Oh, do you have
this? You got to go in deeper.
This fermentation room here, we have it for natural wrappers.
Okay.
And the fermentation is done in this unit. We are both. About 3,500 to 4,000 pounds each. And the fermentation process takes from 2 to 6 months, depending on the product.
2 to 6 months to ferment?
Yeah, as I explained before, during the fermentation process, the tobacco releases ammonia, carbon dioxide, and get
nicotine dissipates.
Aroma, nicotine reduces. Also.
It also loses sugar, I think you said, which I hadn't heard
and
before.
And the pH also might go down a little bit.
Oh, pH goes down too.
Yeah. So those are the things that happen here. And before we take the tobacco out of here, we try to smoke some small fumas made of it.
Fumas,
make,
yeah.
Make sure it has a good taste, aroma, a good burning quality, the ash is white and everything. And then we send the tobacco for packing and then for warehousing and aging. So that's a process that we go through. Here we monitor the daily we monitor the temperature. Every box has a thermometer.
How hot does it get on the inside of these stacks?
We don't allow it to go above 110 degrees Fahrenheit.
Ah, 110?
If it goes above that, we turn.
Okay.
And turning it means that whatever is on the outside, at bottom and top, putting in the middle, and whatever is in the middle, bottom and top, putting in the center of the bowl. The idea is that all the tobacco hands are exposed the same time in the inside of the bowl and outside of the because we want uniformity.
So the top goes to the bottom and the bottom goes to the top?
No, the top goes in the middle.
Oh, the top goes to the middle?
The bottom goes in the middle. The outside goes to the middle.
Middle to the outside. To the outside.
We believe that in the middle is in anaerobic condition. This outside is aerobic condition, so we want all the tobacco to have half of the time anaerobic, half of the time aerobic. In order to ensure uniformity, so that when you smoke a cigar, you don't see much difference between one and the other. If you have uniform fermentation, so that's what it's done here.
So this is where you actually ferment these things?
Yes.
So okay, so you use like a traditional
No pilones?
Not for wrappers, not for wrappers.
Not for wrappers.
We use the pilone for the
filler.
You should totally do that. Shh, tobacco is sleeping.
One that you saw down there, but here the wrapper and binder with thicker texture are the ones that we are fermenting here. More environmental moisture, but the follow-up is the same.
Maduro wrapper, higher moisture content?
Yeah. A lot higher, from 92 to 96%.
92 to 96. As opposed to, it was, what, 80 in the other one, 85?
81 to 85 in the other one. And the one downstairs was 77 to 81.
Okay.
So, depending on the tobacco and the purpose, we manage the moisture in the environment.
Higher temperatures in the Maduro room, in the fermentation. Higher humidity in here too.
Connecticut Havana, or black label. This is the first stage. It takes about 6 months fermentation.
Six months.
This is the second stage. We fermented for 6 months, then aged in the aging room in the warehouse for 1 year. Then we bring it back. Add more moisture to it and put it in fermentation for 2 months. And then add more moisture and put it in the last fermentation for 1 month, and that you get the dark Maduro.
Considerably darker, yeah.
I think it's the base is really well. I use it for work after.
Put your hand there.
Yeah, do that video.
Put my hand there. Oh, wow, that's warm.
Uh-huh.
Very warm.
Yeah.
Muy caliente, I believe, is the way to say that.
Toasty.
Bailing box.
With all the identification
and everything. Is that a press? Is that what that is?
Yeah.
Okay. Pressing some tobacco. It's good. Pretty compacted. I'm gonna remake the box. the end result. It's a new delivery of tobacco here, or?
We storage here from O.J. Thrall, which is the one that produces the Conerico shade for Macanudo. So those grades that are not used for Macanudo, we storage for him here, and he asked us to sample all these bales, because there is some customer of him that is coming to see the samples.
Oh, okay.
That's why you see them on the floor. You see
some box. Oh, Connecticut shade. Macanudo.
2014 crop.
What's the humidity in here? It doesn't feel that high.
No, we stay here 72 to 76%.
Humidity? Mm. How much is the humidity?
72 to 76. That's what we.
The temperature.
And the temperature is the environmental temperature. Yeah. As long as it's below 90 degrees Fahrenheit, we're okay. Oldest?
Oldest.
Bale here.
Yeah. Or anywhere in our inventory.
We have from the 1998, or we have Cameroon, very old also.
1998 Cameroon? Mm-hmm.
We saw that bill last time.
You saw it? Oh, okay.
Rick Rodriguez showed it to us last in 2011.
Yeah.
I said, what's that for?
So is that the...
Thank you, I tell you.
Yeah. It's always secret.
Is that the same stuff that was like on the 160, the Parties 160 then?
When they add the water to the vehicle, they put it, they pack it into the box, and then we take it to the next process. For example, this is Havana, Ecuador. This is not permission, yes.
The idea is, before we process the tobacco, as regards of the stemming process, we first condition the tobacco to avoid breakage of the tobacco. So once the tobacco has been conditioned with the proper moisture, we leave it here for at least one day, and then the next day the tobacco is able to be used in the stemming process. So we separate right and left side from the leaf. So if we send the tobacco like this, of course, breakage percentage is going to grow.
There's a lot of people leaving and coughing in here. Whoa! Whoa! Oh God, leaving, running away.
What's the name of it?
Connecticut,
Sumatra, Cameroon. Sumatra, Cameroon, and
Connecticut.
Okay. Sumatra, Connecticut, and Cameroon. This is a slower, so we need to keep the tobacco from 2 to 3 or 4 hours in the room, so the humidity can get through all the
yeah.
Perfect.
Yeah.
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 How's it smell in there?
Awesome.
Nice.
Cameroon.
Cameroon.
Beautiful.
So it's on the Cuiva?
Yeah.
Cuiva. Want to smell it?
Yeah. Hard to smell all the... There's so much ammonia in here.
Too much in
it. Yeah. There's a lot of ammonia. But it's... pretty awesome.
Different cigar sizes and brands that we have. Macanudo is top priming, I mean the best quality tobacco that we can use. Then you have other sub brands that they are not, do not require a class A, let's say, grade type tobacco. So we play around with the selecting process.
A Cameroon, we use Cameroon for Coiba and Portagas. So what we do here is what we classify the leaf by size A, B, C, and D, and by color. The darkest one is for Portagas, and the lighter one is for Coiba.
Okay.
We separate the ones that have holes, so we send that to binder, and that's all what we do here. So then we package and make a ticket. That box goes to quality control, and if quality control approves that, we send it to the manufacturing process. If not, we come back here and we need to work that to work again. Oh, we have to be careful because the left side we have to join into a group. How do you say group?
To group
together and the. And the right leaves we together.
Yeah, correct. And then you see when you have a right wrapper comes this way, 45 angles, this direction. This left wrapper or left binder goes to this direction. 45 degrees angle to the left side, lefty, and righty to the right side. You see that on a cigar.
For example, this is a right leaf.
Yeah. There are some rollers. They prefer right or left leaves.
Exactly.
Whatever
provides
the best
goal.
Whatever it takes.
Yeah. Yeah. This is our left one. Go this way. It's the quality control process. She's one of our analysts. So what she checks here is that the leaf comes with the same characteristics that are as a standard for us. For example, she checks color, size, and quality. For example, if the wrapper doesn't have holes, or if it has holes. If she says that the wrapper is fine, we make a ticket and we send it to the manufacturing process. And we end the process here for certificate, and then we send the bus and they use it there.
Following military tables, military tables.
We use a military table.
So it's like an internal auditing. So for on each card, we take the sample, following the military tables, and then we begin the inspection process. Once it qualifies to be transferred to the manufacturing process, then the tobacco is released to be used in the production of our weekly, monthly scale.
This is an example of military table.
Yeah, here you have the range of leaves, depending upon the quantity of leaves per carton, then the number of samples that you need to take, mm-hmm. and then how you accept and how you reject a lot. That's basically what we do. Mm. Thank you, Xavier.